Huna was a laborer for Sumana, who was a rich man in Sawati. Puna worked very hard, and even when others took breaks and days off, he would diligently continue his work. He felt that working was good because he was doing something valuable with his time. One day, Puna saw the venerable Sariputta walking near the field where he was working. He thought, "How lucky am I that I get to see the Buddha's chief disciple?" But alas, I have no food nor items of value to offer. However, Puna was determined to not let this opportunity pass. He invited the Thera, or venerable monk, to sit down, and offered him a toothpick and water to wash his mouth. The venerable Sariputta understood Puna's intention and took the time to sit down and pick his teeth and then wash his mouth. He did this so that Puna would receive full merit for his good intention and actions. After finishing, the Thera left. Puna was filled with joy at his great luck. He then thought of his wife, who he assumed was traveling to bring him his daily meal. He wished that she would get to meet Sariputta along the way, and that she would offer Puna's meal to Sariputta in order for her to make merit. Then, Puna went back to work. Along the road, the venerable Sariputta saw Puna's wife. He waited and stood off to the side. Puna's wife thought, "Wow, can it be? Is that really one of the Buddha's disciples? It is truly amazing that I have this opportunity. On days that I have something to offer, I do not see anyone worthy to offer it to. On days that I see those who are worthy, I sadly have nothing to offer. But today, I have a hot meal and am in front of one who is worthy of my dana, my donation." She knelt down and begged the Thera to receive her offering. He accepted, sat down, and ate the meal. After he finished, she requested, "With the merits I have gained from my offering, may my good wishes come true." The venerable Sariputta then said, "Yes, I too wish for your good wishes to come true." And with that, the venerable Sariputta returned to the temple. Puna's wife, however, rushed home to cook a new meal for her husband. She thought, "He must be so hungry now. I must do whatever I can to quickly make a meal and bring it to him." By dusk, Puna had been working all day. He was truly exhausted. Not only that, he had not eaten anything all day. He wondered where his wife was. Puna sat down against a tree to rest his body. As Puna's wife ran to him, she said, "My husband, please don't be angry with me. I saw one of the Buddha's disciples and decided to offer the food I made for you to him in order to create merit. Please do not be mad at me." Puna said, "My love, how could I be mad at you? That was exactly what I wished that you would do." Puna gratefully ate the food his wife made and laid his head on her lap to rest. Puna's wife looked over into the field and saw a bright light. She asked Puna what it was. He thought he must be exhausted from all the work, because when he looked, he too saw a bright light coming from the center of the field where he had been working all day. When they went over and looked, there was gold all over the ground. Puna and his wife conferred and decided that they were poor people. They did not need this much gold. This much gold would be better in the hands of a king. Puna and his wife gathered a sample of the gold and brought it as an offering to the king. They told him what happened and where the gold was. The king, respecting their offering, sent some soldiers to go gather the gold from the field. As they were gathering the gold, the soldiers said, "Wow, our king's merit is great." However, when they said that, all the gold in the cart turned to coal. They rushed back and told the king what had happened. He asked them, "What did you say before the gold turned to coal?" The men said, "We were praising your merit." The king thought about it and told them, "This time, go back and say, 'Wow, Puna's merit is so great.'" The soldiers did what they were told, and when they said, "Wow, Puna's merit is so great," the coal turned back into gold. The king decided that it would be improper for him to take the gold that obviously resulted from Puna and his wife's meritorious deeds. He gave them all the gold, and additionally gave them land and a large estate. Puna now became a wealthy man in Sawati. Puna decided to celebrate his newfound wealth and status by inviting the Buddha and his monks to take their meals at the new house for 7 days. The Buddha accepted, and Puna, his wife, and their young daughter Uttara personally attended to the offerings. At the conclusion of the 7 days of offerings, the Buddha gave a sermon to Puna, his wife, and little Uttara. At the end of the sermon, after internalizing and reflecting on the Buddha's teachings, all three became sotapanas, stream enterers.
What do you think the moral of this story is?
We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.